What is behavior, you ask? It's funny that such a simple question still gives psychologists and other experts in animal behavior a run for their money. It starts with the problem of whether we think that only humans should have behavior and how easily we accept that other animals might behave too. Definitions like behavior is what the brain does, or worse, behavior is what the human brain does, are circular definitions, and they're useless if you want to understand what behavior is and how it comes about, and particularly if you want to understand what do brains have to do with behavior. So here's my definition, and I needed one because I'm in the business of studying what difference does it make to whatever it is that behavior is, that some animals have tons of neurons in their brain and others have just a handful. It didn't need to be a perfect definition or the ultimate definition, but it needed to be simple and it needed to be useful. So here it is. My working definition of behavior is that behavior is any observable action. The chimp plays a video game and actually beats humans at it. That is a behavior. The cat rolls the ball around the circle. Again, and again, and again. That is a behavior. The robot dog does a dance. It's behaving. The plant grows. The moon orbits the earth. Or my favorite, the fan oscillates back and forth. If there is an action, there is a behavior, and the system doing the action is the agent of the behavior. This makes it much easier to understand what brains have to do with behavior, because right off the bat, we realize something really important, that a brain is not required for there to be behavior, and actually not even life is required. As long as there is energy in flux, there is the possibility for observable actions. So the question really is, how does behavior change once there is a brain? Or let's be inclusive, once there is a nervous system, because not every animal, that's the name of all the creatures that have a nervous system, not every animal necessarily has a brain. So here's where we need to stop and define brain and nervous system. The nervous system is a transport network, just like the circulatory and the respiratory systems, with the difference that while the circulatory network consists of vessels that transport blood around the body, and the respiratory network consists of tubes that transport gases to the blood, the nervous system is a transport network made of excitable units, the neurons, that transport signals around the entire body. Inside that nervous system, there may or may not be a brain, a complex chunk of tissue made of multiple different parts, each with a different pattern of organization and function. Without a brain, either the nervous system is just a network without major hubs, or else it's composed of ganglia, like the several you find in the nervous system of the sea hare aplysia, which are just bunches of neurons. A brain, like what you find in the head of a fruit fly, is a chunk of nervous system that gained so many neurons in development that it has several parts with different functions. So, back to where we were. What does a nervous system add to behavior? First, with a nervous system, animals can be big. I don't mean just elephant big. I mean even just big enough to be visible. The problem is that without a nervous system, keeping the parts of the body working together depends on the diffusion of molecules, which are the chemical signals in the body. You could wait 3 years for a molecular signal to diffuse from your brain to your fingertip, but your body would disintegrate well before that. Never mind moving fast enough, much less in any coordinated fashion. So, because nervous systems propagate signals not by diffusion, but through electricity, which we'll talk about some other time, nervous systems allow size to not be a limitation. Creatures can be as large as whales and dinosaurs and still be swiftly mobile. But second, and just as important, with a nervous system, behavior can become flexible and then complex. Flexible means that you don't always do the same thing in response to the same event. That is what organisms without a nervous system are doomed to do. Always the same thing, the same way, with very little flexibility, like that fan oscillating back and forth until the power runs out. But if you have a nervous system, your actions change according to your experiences, and you can actually generate your own internally motivated actions. Actually, as you keep records of previous events, what we call memories, you gain a past. And because the nervous system allows you to evoke those memories and make internal simulations of what could come to be, you gain a future. So with the nervous system, animals gain a behavioral repertoire, a whole gamut of different things they can do in different ways depending on context, past and recent events, and even on desired future states. Behavior with the nervous system becomes more and more unpredictable. The word that describes all of the above is really flexible. And I'm going to go ahead and say the I word. With a nervous system, behavior can become intelligent. That's right. I propose that a great working definition of intelligence is behavioral flexibility. Come visit my virtual office for a crash course in neuroscience, and I'll tell you why.